welcome back to TPS. The 2020 NFL season is almost upon us, and all 32 clubs have the bulk of their roster set in place. So which offenses will light up the scoreboards aplenty in 2020, and which ones will be downright dreadful? Here are the five best NFL offenses heading into 2020, and the five worst. At TPS, we post videos every single day, so don't forget to click the subscribe button to subscribe. Then click the notification bell to be notified when we post a new video. Number five best Tampa Bay Buccaneers. Led by offensive guru Bruce Arians, you know the Buccaneers will be lighting up the scoreboard in 2020. With Jameis Winston last year, the Bucs finished third in total yards and a tie for third in scoring offense. Winston also led the league with 5,109 passing yards, all while pulling off the first 30-touchdown, 30-interception season in NFL history. Even with Winston's constant miscues, the Bucs were an offensive juggernaut, and in case you missed it, they pulled off a couple of major acquisitions that could very well change the landscape of the franchise. Rather than retain Winston, the Bucs went all in on the Tom Brady sweepstakes in free agency, and they inked him to a two-year deal worth $50 million. A month later, Rob Gronkowski revealed his plans to come out of retirement, and the Bucs acquired him via trade from the New England Patriots. As if the Bucs' offense wasn't already scary enough with Chris Godwin and Mike Evans, the best wide receiver duo in the NFL right now. Tight ends O.J. Howard and Cameron Brate can also make the big play when called upon. A 43-year-old Brady is probably an upgrade over Winston here. You can argue that Tampa isn't a legitimate Super Bowl contender, but there's no reason to believe their offense will miss a beat in 2020. If anything else, they'll be even better. Number 5 Worst New York Jets. The Jets were supposed to take significant strides in 2020. Sam Darnold was going to progress as a sophomore. Free agent pickup Le'Veon Bell was going to be a force in this offense. New head coach Adam Gase was going to maximize the skill sets of Darnold and Bell. Well, none of that happened. The Jets finished a pitiful 31st in scoring offense with 17.3 points per game last season, and they finished with the fewest total yards, averaging just 273 per game. Losing Darnold for three games early in the season due to mono didn't help either. Bell produced in the passing game, but he had just 789 rushing yards and three touchdowns, averaging a disappointing 3.2 yards per carry. Now, Darnold and the Jets began to turn things around in the second half, winning six of their final eight games to salvage a 7-9 record. But the front office did very little to improve the offense around Darnold. They lost top wideout Robbie Anderson in free agency and replaced him with Rashad Perryman. They drafted Baylor wideout Denzel Mims in round two, but can the two newcomers step in and produce right away? Hopefully, because Jamison Crowder can't be Darnold's only reliable pass catcher. The good news is that the Jets' offense can't fare much worse in 2020 compared to last season. The bad news is that the playmakers aren't really there for Darnold, so even if he improves, it'll likely be marginal. Number 4 Best Dallas Cowboys. Despite missing out on the postseason, the Cowboys still finished first in total yards last season by a comfortable margin, averaging 431.5 yards per game. They also finished 6th in scoring, averaging 27.1 points per game. And as scary a thought as it is for the rest of the league, the Cowboys' offense should be even better in 2020. Somehow, Oklahoma product C.D. Lamb fell to the Cowboys in the 17th spot. Now, Dak Prescott has a new toy to complement Pro Bowler Amari Cooper and 2019 breakout star Michael Gallup. Did we mention the Cowboys have some guy named Ezekiel Elliott at running back, and that their offensive line is consistently a top 5 unit in the league? But the Cowboys always underachieve, the haters say. Yeah, well, things could be different now that Jerry Jones has hired Mike McCarthy as head coach after finally moving on from Jason Garrett. With a stud QB, three big-time playmaking receivers, an elite running back, and a superb O-line, the Cowboys' offense will be a joy to watch in 2020. Number 4 Worst Chicago Bears. The Bears' offense should be at least average given the talent on the roster. Allen Robinson is coming off of a 1,000-yard season. Anthony Miller showed what he can do with some monster performances down the stretch. And the combination of David Montgomery and Tariq Cohen gives Chicago one of the league's better backup duos. Unfortunately for them, all that talent seems to be negated by the giant hole they have at quarterback. After a solid sophomore season, Trubisky struggles mightily in year 3, averaging a lowly 209 yards per game while throwing just 17 touchdowns. The Bears did acquire Nick Foles in a trade with the Jags for some insurance, but the rest of their offseason was pretty disappointing. GM Ryan Pace sure loves his tight ends. He overpaid for his past as prime veteran Jimmy Graham before reaching for Cole Kmet with the number 43 pick in the draft. Not sure the Bears will get much out of either guy. It'll be interesting to see what Foles can do if he takes over as starter. At least the offense can't be as bad as the unit that averaged a horrendous 17.5 points per game last season. Or can they? Number 3, best New Orleans Saints. The Saints have always been an offensive juggernaut under Drew Brees and Sean Payton. That won't change in 2020, even with Brees on the wrong side of 40. Despite losing Brees for 5 games last season due to a thumb injury, the Saints offense didn't miss any beats. Backup Teddy Bridgewater won all 5 of his starts, and the Saints finished 3rd in points scored, averaging 28.6 per game. Superstar wideout Michael Thomas is coming off an MVP-like year in which he set the single-season record for receptions with 149. He also led the league with 1,725 receiving yards, making a strong case for himself as the best receiver in the NFL. Sorry, Julio Jones. The Saints once again got steady production from Alvin Kamara in both the rushing and passing games. Veteran tight end Jared Cook produced nicely with 43 receptions for 705 yards and 9 touchdowns. As if this group wasn't already explosive enough, they added veteran Emmanuel Sanders in free agency, finally giving them a true number 2 wideout. Sanders has played in 3 Super Bowls, winning it all with the Denver Broncos in the 2015 season. He's good for 800 plus yards a season when healthy. He will make a huge difference as the Saints try to get through their string of postseason heartbreaks once and for all. Number 3, worst Miami Dolphins. If Tua Tagovailoa is the starter from week 1 and if he stays healthy, we will probably regret putting the Dolphins on here. But for now, we're assuming Ryan Fitzpatrick will start at least some of the games. On top of that, the limited set of offensive weapons in Miami does pose some cause for concern. Devontae Parker is coming off a breakout year in which he caught 72 passes for 1,202 yards and 9 touchdowns. But outside of Parker, Miami lacks game changers and consistent playmakers in the passing game. We love the Jordan Howard and Matt Breida offseason pickups. Those two should help the rushing game. But Miami had the worst-ranked O-line by Pro Football Focus for 2019, so the running backs have their work cut out for them. The Dolphins will be a lot of fun to watch in 2020 with Tua in town, but the offense should expect some bumps in the road. It's going to take another year or two before they really take off. Number 2, Baltimore Ravens. First in scoring offense, second in yards, a single-season record of 3,296 rushing yards, and oh, our reigning MVP quarterback, Lamar Jackson. Yeah, the Ravens' offense was pretty good last season, wouldn't you say? Not to mention that in addition to this record-breaking 1,206 rushing yards for a quarterback, Jackson also led the NFL with 36 touchdown passes. Simply put, the man had an MVP season like no other. And yet, this group could be even better in 2020. How, you ask? Well, one has to think Jackson will learn from another disappointing home playoff defeat. Naturally, experience and maturity will make Jackson and stud wideout Marquise Brown that much better over time. The Ravens also drafted 2 new weapons for Jackson: Ohio State running back J.K. Dobbins and Texas wideout Devin Duvernay. That will take some of the pressure off Brown, Mark Ingram, and Mark Andrews. They may not break all these records again, and Jackson may not repeat last year's ridiculous stat totals. But this Baltimore offense will remain a top-tier unit for many years to come. Expect them to be a top-5 offense in points and yards once again for 2020. Number 2, worst Jacksonville Jaguars. Gardner Minshew was a pleasant surprise last year, winning 6 of 12 starts on a frustrating Jaguars team. But opposing defenses will have more game film to study on him now. And let's not forget the Jaguars play in a brutal AFC South that features 3 playoff contenders. The injury-prone Leonard Fournette pieced together a career year in 2019, posting 1,152 rushing yards and 76 receptions for 522 receiving yards. But his name has popped up aplenty in trade rumors, so who knows how long the Jags offense will be able to rely on him, if at all. DJ Chark enjoyed a breakout year with 73 receptions for 1,008 yards and 8 touchdowns last year, and the Jags will hope for some production from rookie second-round pick Laviska Shenault Jr., as well as veterans D.D. Westbrook and Keelan Cole. Still, Fournette's injury history and lack of Pro Bowl talent on offense and a lackluster O-line led us to one conclusion. This offense isn't going to do a whole lot in 2020. number one best Kansas City Chiefs. The Chiefs had the league's best scoring offense in 2018. They followed it up with the Super Bowl 54 championship. Who else is going to be number one on this list? Patrick Mahomes is the best player in the NFL right now. There shouldn't be much denying that. An MVP award and a Super Bowl ring and a Super Bowl MVP within your first 2 years as a starter? Move aside, Brady. It's not Mahomes' league now. Mahomes' superhuman abilities are one thing, but he's also got a special set of weapons to work with, including future Hall of Fame tight end Travis Kelce and speedy wideout Tyreek Hill, plus other complementary pieces in Sammy Watkins, Mecole Hardman, and Damian Williams. They also used their first-round pick in 2020 on potential stud running back Clyde Edwards-Helaire. So let's recap. They have one of the best offensive minds in head coach Andy Reid, the game's best quarterback, the game's best set of offensive playmakers, and did we mention they're defending Super Bowl champions? Yeah, these Chiefs are going to light up the scoreboard at plenty in 2020. They're unquestionably the best offense in the NFL right now. Number 1 Redskins. The Redskins have had the league's worst scoring offense in 2019, averaging just 16.6 points per game. Hiring Ron Rivera as a head coach is a nice starting point for the rebuild, but this offense is going to be a work in progress for a while. Terry McLaurin had a superb rookie year with 58 receptions for 919 yards and 7 touchdowns, but no other Washington player hit 400 receiving yards. That's real sad. Adrian Peterson is still hanging on to his starting role, but for how much longer? And don't get us started with this awful O-line that predictably struggled without Trent Williams last season. It's not going to be pretty in 2020. The Redskins have drafted running back Antonio Gibson and wideout Antonio Gandy-Golden, but they're unlikely to be game changers in 2020. Outside of McLaurin and Peterson, Washington just doesn't have legitimate playmakers. Dwayne Haskins and Kyle Allen will fight for the starting job, but are either of them ready? And how will they produce with limited help at the skill positions? Add it all up, and this offense should be the NFL's worst in 2020. Which NFL teams do you think will have the best and worst offenses in 2020? Let us know your thoughts down below. If you're new here and you haven't subscribed yet, now's a good time to do that. Hitting that subscribe button down there. If you like the video, then like the video. We'd really appreciate it. And last but not least, tune in to TPS every single day for more cool videos. We'll see you next time.